Hey guys, what's going on? Mighty Leafy here. Welcome back to another Monster Super League video. So I plan on making a bunch of Colossus videos. Now these aren't what you would call typical how-to videos. They're more like guidelines. Yeah, think of them more like guidelines. So let's say if you're late game and you're struggling with putting together a Colossus team, then this could be something that gives you some ideas. I will be using late game Astromons since I am late game myself, and also Colossus are supposed to be late game content anyways. I'm going to be putting out a video for each Colossus, so check them out if you're interested. Check the Discord out if you've got any questions. There's a few pretty active people there, so if you ask, I'm sure somebody will answer. Right, so first up we have the Dark Colossus. So this guy does Thirst for his normal attacks, then for his active he does Seal. His half HP active does Silence. So I would strongly advise bringing nukers that can nuke on their passive skill. This Colossus also does Retribution damage, so basically every fifth mon that hits him takes a fixed amount of damage. So you can bring tanks to tank this, and you can just, you know, count the turns somewhat. Right, so first up, my first team has the Dark Chloe lead. She's here to give the crit damage lead as well as to inflict attack down with her passive. You know, just so my first team can survive a little bit longer. Her active is Courageous Strike, but since it's on her active, I kind of don't really rely on it popping off too much. But if it does, then it's bonus damage, so yeah. Next up, we have the Light Fenris. Light Fenris, you know, she's donning my cowboy costume, so I try to use her wherever I can. Anyway, she's here for the 3-turn defense down. Her active is Shock, which the Colossus is immune to, but doesn't matter. It's not what she's here for. Aside from the defense down, she's actually also here to tank that retribution damage. So she gets to be the one that does the fifth hit. You know, takes the retribution damage, doesn't really phase her because, you know, she's built for it. The Light Wendigo here for the passive Courageous Strike, obviously. He's a nuker. Same thing with the Light Siegfried. Now, sometimes Dark Chloe and Light Siegfried pops off with their actives, and it's insane, but most of the time that's not really the case. That's okay, they still do their job. Right, so Team 1's goal is basically to bait out the Colossus's half HP active as quick as possible. You don't really don't want this fight to be dragging out too long, because these Colossuses start buffing themselves and the fights just get harder and harder the longer they become. After Team 1 gets hit with the half HP active, you know, they might get killed, but if they live, then they keep on nuking, and if not, then it's up to Team 2 to carry that task onwards. So Team 2 is basically set up to burst him down while he's low. Now, Team 2 has Light Verde as the lead. And she gives a attack lead. Aside from that, she also is here to siphon the Colossus's SP so that he doesn't really get an active off his SP bar. Her active skills heals the team if needs to be. And, you know, they're all glass cannons, so it kind of really helps out sometimes, but not really all the time. Because sometimes they just straight up, you know, dead. But she's also here to tank the retribution damage as well. She's not fully leveled up just yet, nor is she fully gemmed, like maxed out gemmed. So I think it's gonna be a little bit of a risky maneuver maybe, but I think it should be okay because my nukers can probably end the second phase of the fight rather quickly. Alright, so next up I have the Dark Thor. He's the debuffer. He's gonna be doing defense down, potential nuker if his active comes up. But also, like I said, because it's on his active, it's not going to be relied upon, because this Dark Colossus, he does Thirst, Seal, and Silence, so like, it's insane. Anyways, next up we have the Water Balrona. So she's also going to be a nuker, you know, passive Courageous Striker, what can I say? Then we have my Fire Shinobi, so it's same deal, passive Courageous Striker, and yeah. Okay, so make sure the auto button's off, and then the Colossus is here, all right, turn one. Do the debuff, and then it's just okay. So there's four hits, and then the next hit's gonna be the fifth hit. Alright, so the fifth hit goes to Fenris. And then the others just do all the other hits. Right, so they've obviously achieved their goal of getting his HP down below half, proccing his half HP active. Right, so usually this active here kills your entire team. And when it kills your entire team, you want to switch onto the second team and debuff him. And then kill him as well, damage him as well as lower his SP bar. But okay, I guess my Astromons are a little bit too strong to do like a good demonstration of what it might be like to be late game, but not quite late game, you know? Wow, that's a weird problem to be having. Let me just try once again. Alright, so what I think I'm gonna have to do is replace one of these guys with just some random mon, and then I'll be able to sort of simulate the half HP type thing. Okay, so check the auto's not on, that's good. And then just do that. Oh, it resisted. Okay, well, I don't know. Let's just go with it. Okay, so everybody is thirsted, so you can't really rely on actives for this, like I was saying in the team thing. Alright, so that's good. Look, his HP is just about, like, it's just above half, so this next attack, it'll make it go over half, but okay, good. At least he's not obviously, like, dead type deal, but okay, so typically this is what might happen after he uses his half HP active attack, is that you might lose most of your Astromons. So I only lost the one. But sometimes you might lose most of these. But if you lose your nukers, then you gotta change to like the second team. Cause the longer this fight drags out, the more he has to, you know, the stronger he gets because he buffs himself throughout the course of the fight. So you switch to the second team, and then you debuff him. Okay, so that failed. Now you see one of his minions, or both of them actually, has full SP bar, so he's gonna get a heal. You can choose to SP siphon the heals, but personally I don't think it's worth it. I think it's better to keep him SP siphoned at all time, just so he doesn't do the active via his SP bar, because that one really will probably kill your team, you know, because it does quite a lot of damage. So I choose to siphon him, although you should probably wait until the last turn to siphon him, because every time you attack him he gets a little bit of an SP bar going on. You see, every time you attack him, he gets a little bit of an SP bar going. So yeah, if you're gonna siphon him, do it last, after all your attacks and stuff. But try to time it so that the SP siphon person is like gonna tank the retribution hit, if you know what I mean. So it can be a little bit confusing sometimes, but you know, just try. So at this point, probably just kill him. Ooh, nice. I got a Siegfried Soulstone. Alright, so that's basically gonna be the Dire Colossus. Not the most difficult, but not exactly the easiest. If you struggle with it, that's fine. You probably just need better nukers, preferably with Courageous Strike on their passive, but you know, that's not really up to you. That's just whether the game decides to give it to you or not. Give it to you. not the most difficult, but not exactly the easiest. Anyways, check out my Discord server if you guys have any questions. Bunch of people there to answer your questions if you guys are interested in, you know, stuff about this game. Talk about anime there. We play Monster Hunter World. But yeah, with that being said, guys, I'll catch you guys on the next one.